God bless you, loved ones. Welcome to the Word with Chester. Today we'll continue study in the 15th chapter of the book of Leviticus. I do thank God for all of you that are logging on to watch this ministry. It's such a great blessing to me to know that you are watching. When you take the time to send me that thumbs up or let me know that you're watching, follow me, or whatever you do on the World Wide Web to let me know that you're there. It's a blessing to me, and it is like you saying amen to my preaching. And I want you to know how much I thank God for you. God is doing so many great things through this ministry, and I'm grateful to all that He is doing. I ask that you pray for us on a daily basis, that God will get the glory out of all that we do, and word my mouth as we study the Word of God. I need your prayers, and I ask that you do so daily. Well, we'll begin our study today, or continue this study in the 15th chapter of the book of Leviticus. The Bible reads in verse 16, "And if any man's seed of copulation go out from him, then he shall wash all his flesh in water and be unclean until the evening." Now, I'm going to do all that I can not to go rated X in this particular passage of scripture, but to be blunt with you, God is stipulating and letting them know what is unclean if a man's seed go out from him in copulation. What do you mean? If he's having a sexual intercourse with a woman, when that seed passes from him into the woman, I'll read again so you can understand. "And if any man if any man's seed of copulation go out from him, then he shall wash all his flesh in water and be unclean until the evening." Be unclean until the evening. No, it didn't say you were unclean forever, but you were unclean until the evening. And we're not going to go into any biology on this particular passage of scripture, any biology on sexual intercourse and things of that nature, but the Word of God is saying what it means. Now in verse 17, "And every garment and every skin whereon is the seed of the copulation shall be washed with water and be unclean until the evening." Well, you understand the act of sexual intercourse and all that goes with that. The sheets that are there, or in this case, the skins, the garments and the skins and all of these things that may have been laid on, they had to be washed and be unclean until the evening. Now let's continue reading. "The woman also with whom man shall lie with seed of copulation, they shall both bathe themselves in water and be unclean until the evening." In other words, both of them need to bathe themselves in water and be unclean until the evening. What do you mean unclean? In other words, separate yourself for a time and not mingle all through Israel. Separate yourself and be unclean until the evening. Verse 19, "And if a woman have an issue, and her issue in her flesh be blood, she shall be put apart 7 days, and whosoever touches her shall be unclean until the evening." If a woman have an issue, you know the biology of it, or she's on her cycle, or whatever the case may be, something of that nature, she had to be put apart 7 days, and whosoever touched her shall be unclean until the evening. Now get that picture now. In verse 20, "And everything that she lieth upon in her separation shall be unclean. Everything also that she sitteth upon shall be unclean." Can you understand what God is doing and why He's stipulating these things? If a woman she has this issue, or she's bleeding from her body, everything she sits on will be unclean and had to be washed after this particular time. In verse 21, "And whosoever touches her bed shall wash his clothes and bathe himself in water and be unclean until the evening." in verse 22, and whosoever touches anything that she sat upon shall wash his clothes and bathe himself in water and be unclean until the evening. Verse 23, and if it be on her bed or on anything whereon she sitteth, when he toucheth it, he shall be unclean until the evening. Can you understand what God is saying? In other words, when you come together with someone, or if she is on this time of the month, you're unclean. If you even if you touch the things that or touches her, you'll be unclean until the evening. Now, verse 24, and if any man lie with her at all, and her impurity be upon her, he shall be unclean 7 days, and all the bed whereon he lieth shall be unclean. What do you mean? If you have sex with her while she's on her time of the month, you will be unclean as well. The man will be unclean as well for the full time of her purification. If it's 7 days she had to be and abstain from being out, the man would have to abstain that same amount. Do I need to read that again? Verse 24, if any man lieth with her at all, and her impurity be upon him, he shall be unclean 7 days, and all the bed whereon he lieth shall be unclean. Shall we continue reading? And if a woman have an issue of her blood many days out of the time of her separation, or if it run beyond the time of her separation, all the days of the issue of her uncleanness shall be as the days of her separation. She shall be unclean. What are you talking about? If she have an issue of blood, or she continues bleeding beside the time of her menstruation, if she continues bleeding longer than that, will her separation have to be the same amount of time that she bled, even over the 7 days that she was in that time of month? I hope I'm not being too graphic in this, but we are reading scripture. Verse 26, every bed whereupon she lieth, all the day of her issue shall be unto her as the bed of her separation, and whatsoever she sitteth upon shall be unclean as the uncleanness of her separation. Everything she set it upon for that complete time of duration shall be unclean. Verse 27, and whosoever touches those things shall be unclean, and shall wash his clothes and bathe himself in water and be unclean until the evening. And if she be cleansed of her issue, then she shall number to herself 7 days, and after that she shall be clean. In other words, after the time, after the flow stops, then you still separate yourself 7 days, and you shall be clean. Do I need to read 28 again? But if she be cleansed, of her issue, then she shall number to herself 7 days, and after that she shall be clean. Now let's continue. And on the eighth day she shall take unto her 2 turtle doves or 2 young pigeons, and bring them unto the priest to the door of the tabernacle of the congregation. Now, after she's clean, after she separated herself the 7 days, then on the eighth day she bring turtle doves and pigeons, bring them to the priest to the door of the tabernacle of the congregation. Let's read. And the priest shall offer the one for a sin offering, and the other for a burnt offering, and the priest shall make an atonement for her before the Lord for the issue of her uncleanness. No, God is not saying that you're a terrible person because the natural things in life take place. But yet, he has put away, set away for even your sins to be forgiven, bringing the two turtle doves or the shedding of blood for the remission of sin. Now we can't say you sin because the natural things happen in your body, but God, he always knows what he's doing, and he sets a way for us to always have our spiritual side in tune with him. Always set a way for even if in our time of trouble that we say the wrong thing, do the wrong thing, act the wrong way, we can receive pardon for what we've done or an atonement for what we've done. Remember I say I will never tell you you need to sacrifice anything. Why? Because Jesus sacrificed his life for you and I. Thank God for Jesus and the sacrifice that he made for us, so that we don't have to do all of it sacrificing animals and shedding blood of animals. Jesus shed his blood once and for all for your sins and mine. Now let's read verse 31. Thus shall ye separate the children of Israel from their uncleanliness or uncleanness, that they die not in their uncleanness when they defile my tabernacle that is among them. You got to understand, when you come before the Lord, he wants you to clean up. He wants you to come with the right attitude, and all the things of life that happens, you need to clean yourself up from, especially when you come to the tabernacle. 31 again, so you can understand. Thus shall ye separate the children of Israel from their uncleanness, that they die not in their uncleanness. Uncleanness. That they die not in your uncleanness. I don't care what you get in. God has a way that you don't have to die in your mess. You don't have to die in your sin. He's got a way for you to be cleaned up. Thus shall he separate the children of Israel from their uncleanness, that they die not in their uncleanness, when they defile my tabernacle that is among them. Now let's read verse 32. This is the law of him who hath an issue, and of him whose seed goeth from him, and he defiled therewith. He is defiled therewith. Well, you got to understand, God has a way to get you back in right standing, number one with him, and also with yourself. Well, verse 33, and of her who is sick of her impurities, and of him who hath an issue of the man and of the woman, and of him that lieth with her, that is unclean. You got to understand, God knows humanity, and I don't care if you put a law out there, somebody going to find a way to go by it or break it or do something. But you got to understand, God has a way for you to be cleaned. God has a way for you to be atoned for. And I thank God for the blood of my Lord and my Savior Jesus Christ. All of us would be lost if it was not for him. If there was not a way of an atonement, we would all be dead or lost in our sins. But I thank God for my Jesus. Even the carnal things that we do in life, he has a way for you to be cleansed from it. And that's through the acceptance of his sacrifice. Just saying yes to his will. And I tell you, from time to time, well, I say every day, you ought to thank him for the sacrifice that he made for you, for your sins. You ought to thank him because he didn't have to do it. He did it willingly. He shed his own blood so that you and I, our sins may be atoned for. I thank God for my Jesus every day. He's a wonder in my soul, and I love him more today than I ever have in my life. I ask that you pray for me and pray for this ministry, and stay with us. If you stay with us, you will have read completely through this Bible, verse by verse and chapter by chapter. Your knowledge of the God of the Bible will grow. In fact, you will know the God of the Bible if you stay with us. I want you to know that I love you, my friends. I love you with the love of the Lord. Remember, our work. I am a professional singer and songwriter. If you buy our work on iTunes, Amazon, or anywhere on the World Wide Web where they sell music, just key in my name, Chester L. Figure Sr. My work will come up, and you can buy one song or a complete album. It's all there for you, and you will be blessed thereby, and you will be a blessing to this ministry. I do want you to know that I love you, my friends. I love you with the love of the Lord. Now, if you want to contact me, you can contact me by writing the Word with Chester Ministries, Post Office Box 200603, San Antonio, Texas, 78220. You can also reach me at my website, www.poemsbychester.com. Remember, I love you, my friends. I love you with the love of the Lord. God bless you.